do with that shot? Where'd you learn that?
Well, I just like have worked like on like my game and things like good goalies are really good high and that goalie was really tall, so like I knew that like to move her really, like you really have to like put in a move, like fake her and like just pull a shot out from like somewhere she won't know. And that's like what I tried to do.
Is that something you learned on your own or is it something that you know someone taught that to you?
Like at camps I was taught like to really like change the level of my shot, and I think I shoot it lower than like you're supposed to, but if like I get it off quick enough, then like I probably won't get like checked. But that's like the goal.
You said you didn't get pulled up your freshman year for 2010.
I got pulled.
You got pulled up.
Yeah, halfway through the season. Yeah, I think also like we lost sophomore and junior year to Medfield and Duxbury, and playing those two teams like this tournament run was definitely like we wanted redemption. We wanted to get back what we had lost. Last year was really both those years were really tough losses, really close games, and like the. Getting back what we lost is probably like the sweetest like victory for us.
You mentioned the senior leadership. I mean, how important is it? I mean, the last couple of games you were down 3-0 today. You were down against Duxbury last game, and you just never gave up and kept it. I mean, how important is that?
Yeah, I think like you just have to always want it. Like they got 3 quick goals in like a minute and 40 seconds, and that leaves still like 45 minutes left in the game, so we really just have to like turn it around quickly, and we went on like a 15-0 run. So I think like as soon as you can change their momentum and start up your own, like that's how we have to win.
What did Coach tell you during that timeout when you guys were down 3-0?
She was pretty upset, but she knew that we were like the better team in general, so she knew that like we were just playing sloppy and not our game, so when like she really screams us and gets in our head, we know that we're doing something wrong, so we picked it up, and with that 15 run, we knew where we were like connected and everything. Yeah, after that timeout, it definitely was a turnaround for us because like they were really controlling the draw at the beginning of the game. They'd win the draw and like go right to cage, and that's how they were able to really get up. And that was like the big talk. Like we have to win the draw. The draw controls really the game. So as soon as you can get the draw, then hopefully like you can possess it in the attack again and get good shots off.
Strong for you guys both during the postseason, both getting turnovers in the midfield of the trap and scoring off them. Is there anything you guys do in practice to do to learn that?
Yeah, we do like situational plays. So like she'll tell us we have like a minute to score and things like that, and we really like work on trying to get it up really fast and like hopefully trying to get off the transition. But if the transition doesn't work, we really just like work it around really quick, have all the attackers moving, and really hope for that cutter looking through. Like Maddie and I kind of work together because I know she's really fast, so I really just kind of look for her in the middle, and I can always count on her being there.
Coach kept yelling Gatorade, so you can need a little more detail what that play is.
Gatorade's go. Okay. So on like a set like play, she'll yell Gatorade or Norwell.
So G. Gatorade,
tricky.
Yeah, so I think like that's a big thing. Like we listen to her. Like if someone's not doing a great job on like the free positions, then she'll yell Norwell. And like that's not something to like try to get someone down, because like we all have those games when we can't get those shots off. So it's just like listening to her and like being confident going to cage if she yells Gatorade.
Okay.
How do you try to sum up playing against your cousin?
Everyone asked this, but I don't know. We have like we're really like tight. I see her a lot, and we knew it was going to come down to this. Like we wanted it to come down to this because I played against her my freshman year. I didn't play, but like it was just like the thrill of playing against her. I know she's like really upset now, but it's just like I don't know. It's a different experience playing against her than with her, because I played with her throughout my high school career on the club team, so playing against her was different, but I enjoyed it.
Did you guys talk at all before the game, or
no?
When's the last time you guys talked?
Like a week ago or something like that.
You didn't text her, talk her in that.
Going back to the down 3-0 and what it just tactically, obviously the tempo you guys picked it up quite a bit, but how did you see the middle of the field open the way it did? It just seemed you got like 8-9 second breaks going through the middle of the field. How did that evolve? How did that come about?
A lot of speed on this team. So yeah. If someone gets like that open lane, like we always say, take it. If there's like obviously passing up the field moves much faster than running, but we have such speed on this team that we want kids to take it, like bring it to like the behind the cage, and like then we can set up our offense. But if the faster we can get it down, the faster like we'll be able to stop
it. It almost seemed like you were just holding on to the ball and challenging them to try to cut you off there, and knowing that you could probably get a draw control out of that or something like that, or free possession or whatever. I mean, was that how important was possession in a game like this where they've got a virtuoso there in Megan Hennessy, and you guys, she went half hour between her second and third goals.
I definitely think that like winning the draw and like possessing it, like the big thing is like possessing the attack, like holding it. Like we at the end, like we got it left into running time, and Kara called a timeout and said like we need to really just kind of run down the clock and possess the ball, moving it fast and working it around is like we work on that all the time. Like we work on, we weren't really in a struggle, but we were in like a kind of just situational, just working it around, trying to like hold it until the very end.
Oh, Ryan, sorry.
Sounds good.